If your decal doesn't show up, the first issue might be one of the properties. If there are multiple decals, make sure that z-index is set to a value which will not block the decal. Check your transparency value as well. It needs to be 0, if you want your decal to show. Next property to check is face. When you change this value, it already previews the surface decal will show at. So if you are not sure about which face will it place the decal to, just select this property and see where it will appear. If all of these properties are fine, and if you are scripting your decal, next one is probably the problem you are having. As you can see from this script, everything seems fine. We add two strings here. One is the base URL and one is our asset ID. If you don't know where you can get the asset ID, copy this number from your decal's URL. However, we can see that decal doesn't show up, even though texture property has a value. If you have the same issue, here's your solution. The asset ID we got from the URL isn't actually the decal's ID. If you want to get the decal's ID, copy your asset ID and simply paste it to a decal's texture property, or to an image label. That value you get from there contains your decal URL. You can use that directly in your scripts or just use its number part, and replace with your original number. Here, if I change the number here to the one I just got, you can see that it works now. This process is the same with image label GUI objects. I type down the two numbers here, so you can see that they are completely different numbers. After changing the number, now our decal shows like how it should be. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.